What's up, ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Boy here, and today we're going to be talking about the basic rules and regulations of whitewater slalom. So the aim of the game is to get through the course in the fastest time possible. Races are usually run in a league format, so there's three heats and a single final where the fastest three people are awarded first, second and third place. Each participant gets two runs in each heat and their fastest run is the one they are ranked on. Course designs vary. Length ranges from 250 to 400 meters long. The water varies from class 2 to class 4 white water, and it may contain natural or artificial obstacles like currents, eddies, rapids, rocks, bridge piers and other things as well. There are gates suspended from the air, green ones you can pass going downstream and red ones you have to go past going upstream. There is a minimum of 25 gates and at least 6 of those should be upstream gates. The finishing line must be downstream from the last gate. Other regulations include how wide the gates are, how far above the water they are, and their place where it's possible to navigate through the gate without getting any fouls. There are two types of boats. The first one is a kayak. This is the one where you sit in it and you use a paddle which has blades on both sides. The second boat is a canoe. This one you kneel inside the boat and you use a single blade paddle. Also, during competitions, you must wear a helmet and a buoyancy aid. Other regulations include the minimum size and weight of the boat and accessories that you can and cannot use on the boat and how buoyant the boat is. There is currently four disciplines in the Olympic program. You have the men's single canoe and the women's single canoe, which has been added to the program for the 2020 Olympics. You then have a kayak single for men and then a kayak single for women. In competitions, you may see these abbreviated using the first letter of the boat and the number of paddlers. So for examples, in canoeing, you have C1. This means that it's a canoe and there's one person paddling it. You may also see C2 competition, meaning that it's a canoe and there's two people paddling it. However, this was dropped from the program after the 2016 Olympics. So to start a race, you have the paddler waiting at the top of the course and they start after the klaxon is sounded. And their time starts after they go past the timing gate. This means that there is no false starts in events, meaning that there is no restarts. Okay, so the rules for whitewater slalom are very easy. You're not allowed to touch the gate. Each time you touch a gate, 2 seconds gets added onto your time. You have to go through all the gates in the right order. If you miss a gate, go through the gates in the wrong order, intentionally move the gate with your body or your boat, or go through the gates in the wrong direction. You will gain a maximum of 50 seconds penalty on your time. If you capsize and self-rescue while staying in your boat, so for example, if you Eskimo roll, you can carry on. However, if you capsize and you get out of your boat, it means you'll be disqualified. And if you don't leave the course after you capsize, you'll be disqualified for both runs. If your paddle breaks or you lose your paddle, you can only use a spare paddle if you have it on your boat. And finally, you have to cross the finishing line upright. So if you go past the line upside down, your run will not count. The fastest time at the end of the competition wins. In the event that you get two or more people that get the same time, it will mean that they have tied and then they'll have to share that ranking. If this doesn't sound like your ideal sport, check out other cool sports like water polo, kayak freestyle, stand-up paddleboarding and many other sports. What's up guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Also, comment below on what sport you want to see next. And if you like my videos, hit the subscribe button, it will keep you updated with the latest videos And as usual, ladies and gentlemen, adios.